women in Kashmir and weapon of war. I request to him kindly share your views on human rights violation in Indian occupied Kashmir.
Thank you. Vardi Chief Guest, President Azad Jammu and Kashmir, Sardar Mohammad Masood Khan, the Secretary Jammu and Kashmir Liberation Cell, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. My topic of today's discussion is an overview of human rights violations in Indian occupied Kashmir. The sequence of my presentation is: what are human rights, universal human rights, Indian denial and resistance by people of Indian occupied Kashmir, human rights violation by India. These violations are denial of right to self-determination, heavily militarized zone, enforced disappearances, unidentified mass graves, impunity under draconian laws, mass rapes, massacres, BJP government to change demography, use of pellet guns, next, evidence of human rights violations in IOK, prevalence of mental distress among people in Kashmir Valley, human rights violation in Indian occupied Kashmir from January 1989 to November 30, 2017, and then conclusion. Human rights are rights inherent to all human beings, whatever their nationality, place of residence, sex, national or ethnic origin, color, religion, language, or any other status. All people are equally entitled to these rights without any discrimination. These all rights are interrelated, interdependent, and indivisible. And these rights are granted in Universal Declaration of Human Rights, International Covenant on Civil and Political Rights, International Covenant on Social, Economic and Cultural Rights, treaties, agreements, juristic opinions, and customary international law. Now I will discuss what are the universal human rights. These are right to self-determination, freedom, life, not to be enslaved, not to be tortured. Next, equality before the law, not to be abused, an impartial trial, a just punishment, be honored and respected, move about freely, freedom of thought and expression, peaceful meeting and association, human dignity and human rights. As all you know that Jammu and Kashmir is a disputed territory and India forcefully occupied this part of one part of state of Jammu and Kashmir on October 27, 1947. The United Nations Commission for India and Pakistan adopted a resolution on 5th January 1949. The resolution states, the question of the accession of the state of Jammu and Kashmir to India or Pakistan will be decided through the democratic method of a free and fair plebiscite. Next, Indian denial and resistance by the people of Indian occupied Kashmir. Indian rule in occupied Kashmir can be characterized as militarization, repression, economic deprivation, indiscriminate violence, including extrajudicial killings, disappearances, torture, arbitrary detentions, rape, fake encounters, the denial of democratic process, and the manipulation of elections, etc. People of Jammu and Kashmir tried every peaceful means of resistance against Indian occupation until 1989. Indian systematic oppression and subjugation forced people of Jammu and Kashmir to resort to armed struggle in 1989 along with political struggle. Next, systematic human rights violation by India. First is denial of right to self-determination. India is continuously denying this right of Kashmiri people. This right of nation is granted in United Nations Charter and international covenants. India herself admitted the right of people of Kashmir. When we see the United Nations Commission for India and Pakistan resolution of 13 August 1948, it states with the words that government of India and Pakistan reaffirms their wishes that the future status of the state of Jammu and Kashmir shall be determined in accordance with the wish and the will of the people of Jammu and Kashmir. Next. Heavily militarized zone. The Kashmir Valley is today one of the most militarized zones in the world. In 1990, troops deployed in IOK were 150,000, and in 2016-17, the number is 810,000 to 850,000. The ratio of civilian to forces is about 7:1 in this highly militarized zone. Next. Enforced disappearances. Indian forces are involved in enforced disappearances. A new term, half widow, was introduced. I think Adhya will discuss in detail about this half widows and issues of women. According to Association of Parents of Disappeared Persons, around 8,000 to 10,000 cases of enforced disappearances have been reported since 1989. Unidentified mass graves. According to latest report, 6,228 unidentified mass graves has been identified. These mass graves are in Baramulla districts. These are 1,053. In Bandipora district, 147. In Andhwara district, these are 14. In Kupwara district, these are 1,277. In Srinagar and Budgam district, these are 60. In Poonch district, 2,573, and in Rajouri district, 1,147. Next, impunity under draconian laws. Following black laws are enforced in Indian occupied Kashmir. These laws are the Armed Forces Jammu and Kashmir Special Power Act 1990, Jammu and Kashmir Public Safety Act 1978, Jammu and Kashmir Disturbed Areas Act 1990, Terrorist and Disruptive Activities Act 1990, Unlawful Activities Prevention Amendment Ordinance 2004, the National Security Act. The Army officers has power to shoot or even kill any individual who violate law or suspect to violate law. He can arrest or search without any warrant, and prosecution of the officers is only possible with prior permission of central government. These laws provide impunity to Indian security personnel. According to Public Safety Act, for maintenance of public order, state government can detain any person for 2 years or more without any trial. Detainees can be kept in Indian jails, and proceeding against any official is not allowed. Rape. Indian security forces are using rape as a weapon of war. There are many cases of individual and mass rape and sexual assault. Some reported incidents are Kunan Poshpura incident of 1991, Chananpura 1990, Pazipura 1991, Chaksatpura 1992, etc. Victims are waiting for justice, and many of them had lost their lives due to social, psychological, and medical implications. Next, massacres. In Indian occupied Kashmir, from 1989 to date, 49 massacres, ethnic cleansing attempts were reported. Thousands of Kashmiris have been killed by Indian Army. CPRF killed 51 civilian on January 21, 1990 in Gawakadal during a search operation. In Alamgiri Bazaar, 100 civilians were killed by CPRF on January 22, 1990. Border security forces killed 25 people in Hindwara massacres on January 25, 1990. In Awal massacre on May 21, 1990, CPRF killed 60 civilians. On January 6, 1993, BSF killed 46 civilians in Sopur. On October 22, 1993, BSF killed 35 persons in Bijbihara massacre. Indian Army killed 18 persons on January 27, 1994 in Kupwara massacre. Next. BJP's government designs to change the demography of Jammu and Kashmir. First is settlement of West Pakistani refugees. Some 6,000 Hindu families at the time of partition chose to cross through the borders of Jammu and Kashmir. India settled them in the districts of Samba and Kathua, keeping in mind to change the demography of state of Jammu and Kashmir. Now BJP government is interested to grant them permanent residence certificate. Establishment of Saini colonies. BJP government has asked the puppet government of IOK to identify land for ex-army personnel of India to settle them in Kashmir. Creation of specific township for Kashmiri Pandit. Everyone in Kashmir is ready to welcome Kashmiri Pandits to their respective homes. Indian government want to create separate townships for these non-Kashmiri, for these Pandits, and this is also an attempt to accommodate non-resident Kashmiris in these settlements. This is a plan to make Kashmir another Palestine. Issuance of permanent residence certificates to non-Kashmiri students. These certificates will be issued to the children of non-Kashmiri Hindu families. According to our quote, in the Kishtwar district, 500 such certificates have been issued to students out of proposed 5,000 in total. Abrogation of Article 370 of Indian Constitution. Article 370 provides a special status to Indian occupied Kashmir. Abrogation of this article will abolish the Kashmir's autonomous status. Abrogation of Article 35A. This article is about the right of permanent residents of Kashmir. Due to this article, non-state subject cannot purchase land or get employment in Indian occupied Kashmir. BJP is trying to abrogate this article to grant citizenship to Indians in Kashmir. Next, use of pellet guns. People of Jammu and Kashmir had started a new phase of peaceful liberation movement in July 2016. The military, paramilitary and police are using pellet guns to suppress this movement, and the victims are children, women, youth and even old people. From July 8, 2016 to now, 73 people have lost their complete eyesight, 207 have lost one eye, 972 are at the verge of losing eyesight, 7,485 were injured by pellets, and 1,612 people have lost their vision partially. Even a four-year kid, Zora Majid, was a pellet victim also. Evidence of human rights violation in Kashmir. 94,874 people have lost their lives. 10,000 plus are missing persons. Endless tales of torture, traumatized population, breakdown of socio-cultural support system, highest youth unemployment, uncertainty about future, militarized justice system, divided families, then off-widows, extrajudicial killings, damage of property. Next. Prevalence of mental distress among people in Indian occupied Kashmir. 1.8 million, almost 45% adults in Kashmir Valley have significant symptoms of mental distress. Approximately 1.6 million adults, 41% in the valley, are living with significant symptoms of depression, with 415,000, 10% meeting all the diagnostic criteria for severe depression. An estimated 1 million adults, 26% in the valley, are living with significant symptoms of anxiety-related disorders. Nearly 1 in 5 adults, 90%, are 771,000 individuals in the valley are living with significant post-traumatic stress disorder. Next. Human rights violation in Indian occupied Kashmir from January 1989 to November 30, 2017. Total killings are 94,874. Custodian killings are 7,099. Civilian arrested 142,200 142,851, structural arson destroyed 108,471, women widowed 22,862, children orphaned 107,674, women gang raped 11,026, youth lost their complete eyesight 73, youth lost one eyesight 207, youth at the verge of losing eyesight 972, youth was being damaged partially 1,844. Indian state is involved in gross and systematic human rights violation in Indian occupied Kashmir. Human rights observer and organizations are not allowed to enter in Indian occupied Kashmir. The Act of Indian State in Kashmir, Acts of Indian State in Kashmir are violation of international human rights and humanitarian law. All available resources should be utilized to expose the human rights violation in Indian occupied Kashmir. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Raja Muhammad Sajjad Khan Sahab, for giving a comprehensive overview of human rights violation in Indian occupied Kashmir. Our next guest speaker is Ms. Madiha Shakil. Ms. Madiha Shakil has conducted a research work on legitimacy of freedom struggle in Indian occupied Kashmir under international law. She is working as a junior parliamentary expert in Pakistan Institute of Parliamentary Services. I would request Ms. Madiha Shakil please come to the podium and express her views. Thank you.
Look to this day. This is life. The very life of life, for yesterday a dream and tomorrow a vision. But today makes every yesterday a dream of success and every tomorrow a vision of hope. I place myself under the cares of Allah from the attacks of accursed Satan. In the name of Allah, entirely gracious, entirely merciful. Mr. President and distinguished guests, every year Human Rights Day is observed on 10th of December. This day is observed because on this day, 1948, the UNGA adopted the Universal Declaration of Human Rights. It reflects the conviction that human dignity is at the conviction heart of our societies, and the respect of human rights is essential to the prevention of conflict and promotion of human development. Ladies and gentlemen, although 10th of December is observed throughout the world as Human Rights Day, yet the case of Indian occupied Kashmir is of special attention, where Indian forces have left no stones unturned by violating the Universal Declaration of Human Rights. Ladies and gentlemen, Hazrat Umar Farooq once said, "Man was born free, but why have you kept them in chains of slavery?" Freedom has been the watchword in Kashmir for many decades. Certainly, it is not everybody's privilege to sing the song of freedom. Only those hearts throb for it that actually sees the claws of oppression and human security society and have a courage to speak for the welfare of mankind. The roots of Kashmir freedom movement have gone very deep into history of Kashmir. The people of Kashmir believe in unfettered struggle and are never ready to retrieve and compromise even under untoward circumstances of oppression. In past, Kashmiris revolted against the sale deal of Amritsar and then equally rose against the so-called annexation of India in 1947 and showed to the world the ugliest face of Indian so-called secular democracy. Kashmir struggle is based on right of self-determination under UN resolutions. India is trying to crush this legitimate freedom struggle by curfews, mass killings, forced disappearances, rapes, cordons, fake encounters, detentions, lynching, maiming, abusing, and they are trying to label this indigenous movement as a terrorist movement, which is a big lie. Despite the passage of almost 7 decades, people of Jammu and Kashmir are waiting for the right of self-determination, which was promised by UN. Whereas there are around 25 UN resolutions calling for the solution of the dispute. India is reluctant to grant Kashmiris as their right of self-determination by denying implementation of UN resolutions and occupying the state through deployment of over 700,000 troops. India is clearly violating international law and UN resolutions. It is evident that every claim of India, be it the treaty or so-called treaty of accession or its false claim of tribal invasion in the indigenous movement of Kashmir liberation during 1947, to the present movement which they are trying to connect it with terrorist outputs, that all is based on false allegations, and those are all cock and bull stories. Please, next slide. Next. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, as you all know, that human security is the most important agent of state security. The elements of state security constitute security of individuals, communities, and societies. The basic right to live, cherish, survive and prosper in life is for every human being and is explicitly guaranteed in international law. This is regardless of caste, creed, faith and geographical identity of person or community. Ladies and gentlemen, through these slides I'm going to tell you about whatever is happening in Kashmir and how they are the Indian brutal forces are denying the basic human rights to the people of Kashmir. Please, next slide. Daily cordon and search operation and military crackdowns are the daily routines of Indian paramilitary forces. Next. Entire village remain under cordon and imposition of prolonged curfews. Next. Well, during those operations, they go for house to house search, and they also destroy those houses, they destroy the property.